Well, my dear apes, I guess I have to prepare you for this week. This week, we will have official data for the inflation from December. The problem is that Bloomberg already has some data. According to Bloomberg, year-over-year basis consumer price index likely surged by 7.1% in December, in comparison with 6.8% in November. When we received the data for November at 6.8%, the market was between 7 to 9% in red. If this data from Bloomberg, if these numbers from Bloomberg are correct, surpassing the 7% inflation from December, guys, at least 10% sell-off overall the sectors. Again, this, in my opinion, it's a good moderate scenario, because we can go even further. We can go at the rates that the inflation was at 1982, at the levels of 8.4%, in which, in my opinion, 10% will be easy task. Everything above will be crazy. What does it mean? If tomorrow AMC follows the market in the red line, don't be afraid, don't freak out, okay? Just want to set you for expectations that are manageable, right? This is what we all expect, because the inflation numbers won't be great. I don't expect to be good either. And we all know Bloomberg has a bunch of data. Bloomberg won't be too off the targets. So 7.1%, it's kind of a good news in my opinion. And I know some of you might come up with AMC has a negative beta. No problems that the market is in deep red. Well, if the market is 10% down, believe me, AMC won't be 10% up. Also, hedges most likely have a Bloomberg terminal and they have this data prior me. So hedges are already preparing the algorithms. They're already preparing to play the exact same way. Remember what I said. When the market is deep in red, you can do whatever you want. You can short stocks. You can manipulate stocks. You can basically move strike prices on different options like in a matter of minutes. If you have like 20,000 contracts at the strike price of, let's say, $20, they can move, they can manipulate as much as the contracts volume to move at the five levels highs or at the five levels lows. So basically in these days are always the craziest and the worst for the price action. So the next release for the CPI data for December will be announced on January 12th at 8:30 a.m. In other words, 1 hour before market open, all the sophisticated investors will be able to readjust the algo, put some contracts on the side, and set the stage for another market correction. I said Monday will be very, very tricky, even though the data will be coming on Wednesday. Here is why. Bloomberg is just the first media that is coming out with its own prediction of 7% inflation, beating the November's. So this is interesting, but tomorrow and Tuesday, there will be other predictions. There will be a lot of people speaking on the media, giving a lot of interviews. How the inflation most likely is here to stay. And this 7% most likely will remain at the 7% when we receive the January numbers in February. So until we get the actual data on Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday will be very, very hard days. In my opinion, we can start easily with 4 to 5% sell-offs. Getting closer to the Wednesday's report, we might see even deepening of the sell-off around 6 to 7%, especially on the crypto level. So far, crypto looks like it's rebouncing some of the positions that I bought on the dip already printing. So in my opinion, crypto is already going back. Also, guys, this week we have banks reporting quarterly earnings. As you can see, we have JP Morgan, Citigroup, Wells Fargo. I think the banks will be doing good for one simple reason. Because the expectations for increasing the interest rates is giving higher share prices for each of the banks for potential higher revenue, because the debt will be much more expensive. They will make much more money on the money that they are lending to the companies. So what's bad for the stock market from the Fed actually is good for the banks. Anyway, we're not gonna go over so deeper into expectations and predictions, because we could be wrong. I just want to give you a heads up what you can expect, and looking at your phone, your portfolio, and what the heck is happening Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, right? Just be aware some important numbers should be announced this week that will have a major direct impact over not only AMC but general market. If you have a heat map, you want to wake up with a heat map tomorrow morning, not with individual watch list or your portfolio positions, so on and so forth. Just open the heat map. Okay, guys, I hope the weekend was great. Subscribe to the channel, like this video, and come back for more.